So with that, H2K looking to decide what they want to finally send her to the top lane. We did see Kennen before.
Oduwame as well is one of the stronger top laners in the single clear, is going to be significantly slowed. But Oduwame is in trouble.
Yes, he is. Diamond is there, flashing for the knockup. Oduwame, can he get away? No, he cannot. And Diamond gets first blood. That's four members of Gambit in the bottom side, and they're fast pushing this tower.
Yeah, Pinoy and Edward, however, they're at risk of getting caught out. Level four, there's Pinoy. He's going to fight
dangerously. Jet. Yep, right into it, and they're going to try to grab him. The Lantern will finally be taken. Pinoy gets a chance, eats an Ignite as well.
A lot of damage to play with, and this is just going to be completely safe. There's no one around to contest. Easily.
He has gotten himself pretty quick early gank here, and as Oduwame checks onto Kabushard, some backup from Lulex. Diamond is there to try and interrupt. Can they turn it around? There is the Lee Sin kick. Lulex, Kabushard so very low, and he's gonna get picked off. Diamond now is gonna fall. Oduwame getting that one, a pair of kills for the H2K jungler in top lane.
Gambit has got a kill and assist, and he's been able to help Oduwame get a kill. He's not gonna stop the jumping on Ryu.
Nope, Diamond was trying, but he couldn't quite close the distance. Nick actually eats a charm, very low, burning away. But he should be able to live through that one as Ignite finishes its cycle.
Slightly easier start, hence the score difference. Let's see if SK can take advantage of that. Kabushard is in trouble now.
Yep, it is a 2v1. Kabushard, his health bar starting to evaporate as they spend. Dragon's Rage kick on him, and Oduwame picks up a second kill.
But that's fairly sizable CS lead.
Oh, portal's gone! Oh my goodness, there goes the Annie. And Gambit with their Death Rush set up. Harnan's able to get out, but
3 minutes ahead of Nick's flash, but it's always going to be hard. Look for Ryu on the sideline. He wants to hit Edward or Pinoy with a charm.
He's going to, yes, Pinoy, before he can even react. Charmed and taken down. Now H2K on the chase, looking for Eddie right now. They don't quite have the damage as he burns his flash to get out of harm's way, but they've taken out the big damage threat on Gambit.
Diamond tunnels in a moment. H2K have got the dragon low. Gambit going to try challenge.
Yep, not going to be able to. Diamond pops in, pops right back on out, but H2K...
They're responding better to H2K's plays. One thing that I like, oh, here comes Oduwame from the side.
Yep, he's going to go in with the Maelstrom and now taking extremely low, but H2K is here. The hook caught Lulex, the collateral damage, and H2K have to back away. Can they get the assassination? Combo shard kicked away as he grabs Oduwame, but he gets a double kill on Voidal nonetheless. Nick on the floor, chasing forward. Ryu, extremely low, spirit rushing his way to safety, but Gambit, that was a fight that they were looking for.
On wards from HTK, it's made it quite clear, but I think Gambit are aware. Let's see who gets caught.
Yeah, it's Diamond. The Tibbers comes down, lands up Pinoy, and Gambit are starting to melt, but Yarnen is going to be the first casualty of that one. Pinoy shortly following. Gambit trying to bail out of a bad situation. Nick with a rift walk over the wall. It ends up being a trade of AD carries, but can Nick make the great escape? Oduwame in hot pursuit.
Despite the fact that HTK had a great engage, because Kabushard is in such a great position and so well, and Ryu unable to really get more damage elsewhere. Voidal's down.
Yeah, in the pit. Yeah, Gambit. I like that Diamond immediately used the Void Rush to get within range to try and head H2K off of the pass there. And they're able to push in. They grab Voidal out of position. H2K slow to react. Third dragon over to Gambit now. And had almost the perfect setup. And they just didn't do much with it. And now they're caught on Oduwame, play backwards. He's not going anywhere after that. Zhonya's finishes on up. Goodbye.
Giving the kill to Kabushard. 5-2, red buff. And that allowed Gambit to instantly just push down the middle lane. Waves working in favor of HTK bottom, working in favor of Gambit top. So we need to see which minions get where.
Over the cut. Voidal, he throws down the Tibbers, immediately evaporates now. They've caught onto Ryu, and they take him down. Pinoy picking up another one of those. Turn tail and run, H2K.
This is going to be a fairly easy Baron. Keep an eye on Lulu. He's getting close. He may want to challenge, but this is scary.
No, they chased him away, though. Actually, Nick is going to be able to pick him up. No smite available as two members peeled off to deal with that threat. Eddie taking up a lot of the Baron as it goes down in Gambit's favor.
Another team fight. Really needed to be closer to his team, hugging. It is difficult, but now Hjarnen is going to die.
Speaking of positioning, too, yeah, Hjarnen. You're not infinitely safe on a Corki. Gambit just starting to get these picks, and I feel like H2K's tilting here.
Really do, and Gambit have got control of it. I Warmogs Irelia at 6-2-2 with Triforce and Banshee. That is terrifying. Ryu's in so much trouble.
Yeah, but Nick's the one who does get caught. Maybe they can still turn this one around instantly. Oh my goodness! All that damage, the Maelstrom coming out, but Kabushard picking up another kill. Ryu is gonna grab Eddie. Now Kabushard barely avoiding his own death. Pinoy chasing down Ryu, not quite enough damage or mobility to get that catch. They do trade 1-3, so Gambit still comes up quite ahead. Zess. However, you're absolutely right. It's definitely starting to turn away from them. They're not even really able to do much in their own jungle right here. Ryu, with some backup, will chase Diamond away from that one. And now Lulex trying to chase with the help of Odawamne onto Eddie. They've got the catch back onto him, and they will take the pick, but they still might pay for that. Kabushard teleported in. They look for Hjarn, and here comes Nick. They're blowing them all up. Pinoy with the collateral damages. Odawamne is turned on target. Pinoy's going to find another. They're going to find a third on top of that. Double kill to Pinoy. Odawamne, Hjarnen, and Voidal all down for the price of one Thresh.
Another 1-3. There was no Maelstrom from Odawamne. They're going to carry on chasing.
Yeah, Nick is going.
Kabushard is tearing through H2K. Gambit have got the ability to push these towers. And Diamond's even going to interrupt Ryu.
Yeah, Ryu was trying to back sneaky-like on that one, but Diamond's still chasing him down. They've grabbed a turret. Ryu cannot back to defend this. It's only Lulex here, and Ryu still in the danger zone as Diamond continues to push him away.
Can he land another
Brayseeker?
He can.
He's gonna chase him. So low, yep, Ryu can't do anything. Oh my goodness. Gambit starting to run this game.
So fed and so powerful, they still won the team fight. So we need to see if Kabushard can get another quick teleport.
Diamond, yeah, he's going to the Maelstrom, is on in the middle. However, they caught Ryu, throws down his Hourglass, and immediately still looking for more. Lulex chunked out. Diamond, nearly the same. They get the hook on. They're going to catch Voidal. Not quite enough damage, a double kill. Going over to Hjarnen's way as he goes forward, looking for more. Can't quite catch it. Pinoy moves around. He gets a double kill of his own. However, the kick connects. Here comes the Lee Sin. Lulex trying to blow him up. Diamond still distracting. Finally shut down by Odawamne. This fight has been absolutely crazy, as Kabushard picks up one as well. A 3-3. How bloody was that?
Pinoy goes full Pinoy, finally finding some of the form that he had at IEM
Cologne. He's not done.
He wants to chase down H2K. Now, what happened there was Odawamne got a good ultimate. Area for H2K. Dragon number 5 has been secured. Aspect, you just need one hook to land.
And now they're trying to zone this one out. Okay, here we go, Nick. They've turned the fight. There's the Maelstrom, but they are starting to blow targets up. Nick is a little low himself. Kabushard getting kicked. So tanky on this one, however. Lulex trying to run away into the red buff. And here we go. Ryu is going to pick up Eddie, but it's a consolation prize as they've already lost 3 members. Kabushard coming in. Still really low in this one, but it's going to be a tag team. Diamond coming back. A double kill for Ryu. Can he turn the fight around? They just might have it. A triple kill. Ryu still hanging alive. Not quite burned down as Hjarnen picks up Diamond. In the end, it actually goes H2K's way, but there's still some time on this one as Hjarnen extremely low. Can Pinoy pick him off? Yes. It's a 4-4.
Keep in mind, H2K traded 4-4. Fight here.
They certainly try to find some poke.
So we're approaching 50 minutes. Gambit, despite having a 10K gold lead, just lost a big team fight, but unless they blow somebody out, Pinoy wants
like
to
that.
Go.
Yeah, he spends quite a lot of summoners for that one. Here comes the Kassadin. They get the shutdown, but Nick is going to pay dearly. Odawamne, can they turn the fight after this one? Kabushard going into the back line, kicked away from all that one. Pinoy is going to find the pick onto Odawamne. Diamond, they turn onto Voidal. It's a double kill going over to Pinoy. They have turned up the pressure. They've so far won this fight, but there's still time. Hjarnen, the hook, not going to connect. Straight through the base gate comes Pinoy. Lulex zoned a little bit farther out as Diamond finally will back away from that one. They should be able to grab an inhibitor there, though.
And the team fight. Yes, they blew Nick up very effectively and they got him off the table, chunk him down, and flash engage. Gambit have got Baron, Gambit are going to take Dragon, and they're going to look for somebody to be out of position before they jump in. I mean, to defend, because once again, Pinoy has a very confident play.
Yep, they're going to try to find it. Diamond is the one in the front. However, Odawamne is also frontlining for his team as he throws down the Zhonya's Hourglass. Not quite enough follow-up, and Lulex gets the kickback. Not even the damage they needed. They've lost Voidal. They've lost Odawamne. It's a double kill for Pinoy. Looking for more. How much can he go? That looks like a triple kill. Kabushard comes up with another. Ryu is going to evaporate. Just barely staying alive for a second, but they'll pad that score anyways. There comes the ace. There should be the game. And Gambit Gaming have finally gotten on the board. 1-5 to start the split.
That is going to be a massive confidence boost. You could see Pinoy and Edward jumping for joy as the Nexus explodes. Hugs all around. And you know, it was an exciting game to watch, and it was one that Gambit actually was in control of for most of the match.